With these forms of social controls, to what extent do you think the effectiveness is like more or less for policing of the family and policing through language compared to policing by the state and by legislation? And like, I guess in 1984, like both of them were sort of looked at with the cutting down of the dictionary and through the state itself and like the ministries. So to what extent do you think their effectiveness are more or less?
So do you mean by that that the limitations and the falsifications in that kind of language are things that we're now imposing on ourselves rather than being sort of state sanctioned? So whereas the government in 1984 is actually promulgating a new kind of language and cutting down dictionaries and interfering in the way that we're just sort of doing it ourselves in terms of our slumming away and choosing words and the anterior beings. I think that's a very good point, actually. I suppose, irrespective of where the force is coming from, one of the most disturbing things, David was talking about political discourse and degeneration, and one of the most disturbing things in national life at the moment is the degeneration of the way in which language is used. And it's always, I mean, people have always written and spoken in cliches, it's a historical fact, but then certainly to read a paragraph, I'm not being patronising tabloids, but to read the average paragraph in a tabloid these days is to read a series of words that have no individual meaning on their own, but are simply thrown together like things sticking to each other, like tiny birds coming together to form one large one with no actual thought. I mean, the same can be said higher up the line. I mean, they're just the same kind of spirit sometimes invests articles in The Guardian, it's how journalism gets done, but I think what generation of media in that respect is very...
I mean, my adult lifetime, there's been a significant shift, I would have thought, from sort of predominantly written or literary culture to predominantly visual culture. And I feel that's really quite significant. That's got really quite significant considerations
Love It or Shove It, which is fine, you can take a polar view of something, but the whole tendency of the visual, as well as the written culture, if there's one thing that impedes and inhibits and excludes nuance and subtlety and thinking that something, that a statement might be 60, sometimes an interesting thing, to narrow this debate a bit, just to say, talking simply about, say, something as rarefied as literary. Which is one of my points of advantage. In some cases, the really interesting thing when somebody makes a statement about a literary theory or a writer's work, the interesting thing is whether is the degree between, let's say, 65 to 70% accuracy. You're not sitting there thinking, is he right or is he wrong? You're thinking, to what degree is he right? And then what qualifications can I put in?